I know the name of this tool is a little bit scary, but the concept is pretty simple. Basically, as you're going through the product development process, there are going to be new features for the product that you might want to include, and they're being requested. So it's pretty obvious you can't say yes to all of the features, and this is a good template that you can use to standardize the prioritization and evaluation process. What we've done here is we've outlined three key perspectives: the end user perspective, the buyer perspective, and the development. For each of these perspectives, we have some ranking criteria, and we've provided definitions of the ranking criteria below. On the first tab, all you have to do is weigh each of the ranking criteria so that the total equals 100%. Once you've done that, you go into the feature scoring tab. And again, you'll see the ranking criteria at the top here with the weighting. That's automatically brought across. What you do is you list all of the different features that are being considered, and you score each of these features on a scale of 1 to 10 against the ranking criteria. Once you've completed the scoring exercise, in the rankings tab, you'll see all of the features listed and an overall feature score out of 10 points. You'll also see a breakdown of how the feature scored from each perspective. Now, this isn't really a fun way of communicating these results, so we've created a bubble matrix, and the idea here is you can quickly identify the end user value and also the ease of development, and then the actual size of the bubble is the buyer. So you can quickly identify these features should go into development, these are low-hanging fruit, these are low-value features, and these are features to cut. So not only is this a great tool for evaluating and prioritizing, but it's also a good communication tool as well. Hope you like it.